Hi everyone, this is Ben here with Pierre Paul Driving School. On our lesson today, I'm going to show you how to control the brake pedal. It is a challenge for most of the students to know how to control the brake pedal. After watching this video today, controlling the brake pedal should not be an issue for you. Now, when we begin, this is an automatic car. We only have two pedals. The one further, all the way to the right, it's the accelerator or the gas. Now, let me show you the gas. The one further, all the way to the right. That is the gas. The largest one in the middle, it's the brake. The largest one here, it's the brake. The pedal all the way over to the left, that's a foot restraint. That's where you put in your foot when you're driving. As you're driving, you do not want your foot to be here and you try to brake and the left foot says no, the right foot says right. It's a confusion. It can be problem. That's the reason why they have three pedals, foot restraint. Your left foot belongs there. If for any reason you're not comfortable with the left foot there, it's okay to put it over here. But you cannot have it under any of those pedals. This is your left foot. Now the right foot for automatic cars, that's what you will be using when you're driving. Brake, brake, it's in the middle. Gas, it's all the way over to the right. Now, as you're driving, you do not wanna lift your foot all the way above ground and you go and brake and gas. It will not be a safe way for you to do it. You will get tired quick and uncomfortable. You will not be able to handle the driving like this. Matter of fact, when you have your foot levitated above ground, you tend to hit the brake harder and also accelerate harder. You do not want that. You want your palm, you want the palm of your foot to be on the ground. Okay, on the ground, I'm sorry. Now, when you accelerate, when you're shifting, you want your tip of toe to press pressure either on the brake and you shift over to the accelerator. Let's do it again, a quick exercise. The palm of your foot on the ground, your tip of toe over the brake, nice and smooth, and you shift over to the gas, to the accelerator, very easy. What we do not want to do, we don't want to levitate your foot, put it on the brake and shift it over, put it on the accelerator. It's not acceptable. Now, many students struggling with braking. They're tense to hit the brake too hard, and that's an abrupt braking. It's not acceptable in driving in general, especially when you're doing your road test. And also, that tends to jam the accelerator too fast. Is also not acceptable when you're doing your road test. Now, we have a method that we've been teaching all of our students that will help you 100% mastering the level of the brake as well as the accelerator. Things that for you to understand when you get in any car, the first thing is there for you to try to understand with the brake pedal. It's the level of the brake. It's the brake level is low, or if the brake level is high. What do I mean? There is certain car, when you hit the brake, you have to go all the way on the ground before you finally started to get some braking. Same thing with the accelerator. When you hit the accelerator, you have to go very deep before the car begin to pick up some speed. As you get in the car, the first thing is there for you to understand is at what level the brake really engage or begin to engage, and at what level the gas is taking off is the first thing you need to understand. Now, once you understand that, it will make your life much easier for you to know how to brake and how to accelerate. Now, here's my tips for you for first-time driver. Now, we have a method we call 1-2-3-3-2-1. What is that? When you begin to accelerate, remember the car by itself, after applying the brake to shift to drive, the car tends to drive by itself. Now, what you do? When you take your foot off the brake, you shift over to the accelerator. Before you begin to accelerate, you count of three. 1, 2, and 3. Then you begin to accelerate. What will you realize is that by the time that you're counting, the car is already moving, because it's moving by itself when you shift to drive. Now you're gonna blend in the speed that the car is moving already. Then when you're adjusting yourself in that speed, you can pick up the accelerator. If you just take off the brake, you go straight to the accelerator, the car will be jerking. That we do not want, okay? Let's do it again. Your foot is off the brake. You shift your car into drive. You start your car, you shift to drive. You take your foot off the brake. The car begins to drive, and you count to three. 1, 2, and 3. And three, that's when you begin to accelerate. Nice and smooth, you will blend in within the speed the car was already doing. Then you build from there. If you're doing it any other way, it will take you a long time to get it together. Contrary, we do for the brake. Now, since when we take enough, we go from 1-2-3. Now, when you know that you're gonna come to a stop, you've already seen there is obstruction in front of you to stop. When you take your foot off of the gas, you go over to the brake, you do the same thing, but you're gonna do the inverse. 3, you're gonna start applying pressure. 2, a little bit more pressure. 1, then you come to your final stop. I want you guys to go ahead and practice this and come back in the comment below. Let me know if that worked for you. 9 out of 10, most of our students, that's the way we're showing them how to understand the brake pedal. They are very essential as you do in your lesson for you to understand how to do that. By applying those methods that I just showed to you, you cannot go wrong. If you have not yet subscribed to this channel, you can go ahead by hitting the bell notification icon so we can be notified anytime we release any of these videos like this. And if you find value in this video, please give it a thumbs up.